Hello, moment. Thank you so much for joining my live streaming. Oh, thank you for the two people in the house. Okay, so today we are going to talk about WH question in Spanish. So, one moment. Let me share our live streaming so that we have more people in the house. So, mega, mega shout out. Thank you for joining my live streaming today. Okay, so thank you for the thumbs up. Okay, so today we are going to talk about WH question in Spanish. So actually, not just Spanish, but of course, I do a trilingual tutorial, Spanish, English, and Filipino. So since it's cold, I want to look at my scarf, bufanda. Thank you again for joining me today. Okay, so can you read the writings on the board? One moment. We will... Because the lights reflect on my mini board. One moment. Maybe we will put that this way. I am so sorry for the disruption of our lesson. Thank you again for the thumbs up and for joining me. Okay, so I'll put my mini board here. I think perfect, no? Here. Okay. Ah, can you see the world map? That's my favorite. The world map. Okay, so that would interrogativos. No, in Spanish we call the WH question in English interrogativos. So they have different names of these W questions in English. So first, I love to put always the Tagalog version because normally I do trilingual Spanish, English with Tagalog or Filipino translation. So I put also my language. So anyways, again, thank you so much for joining me today and thank you for the thumbs up. Okay, so interrogativos. These are WH questions in English, but in Spanish, we called it interrogativos. Okay? And remember that in Spanish, all the interrogativos words with accent, con tilde. Nah. ¿Qué? ¿Cuándo? ¿Dónde? ¿Cómo? ¿Por qué? ¿Cuál? ¿Quién? ¿Y cuánto? Siempre va, llevan con tilde. Okay? Always with accent. Because you know in Spanish, that is very important that you put the accent because that changes the meaning of the word, the with accent and without accent. So let's start. Please let me know if you can read the writings on the board. I'm sorry because the reflection of the lights, it reflects on my mini board. Oh. I do not know what to do. Anyways, okay, so like this, like that, like this. Okay, so ¿qué? Okay. Que means in English, what? In Tagalog, ano? That is the translation of que. Okay, so in sentence, I mean, how to use this as a question rather, as a question. ¿Qué estás haciendo? Okay, ¿qué estás haciendo? Like, what are you doing? Okay, ¿ano ang iyong ginagawa? Okay, so that is how you are going to use that interrogativo in the question, ¿qué estás haciendo? Okay? ¿Cuándo? ¿Cuándo means when? We are talking about time. ¿Cuándo? Tiempo. Okay? In Spanish. Hablamos sobre todo el tiempo. So, in Tagalog, that is kailan. Kailan. Okay, ejemplo. Cuando vuelves de tu trabajo. Cuando vuelves de tu trabajo. So, that is when do you get back from work? When do you get back, vuelves? From work, de, from tu trabajo, from work. So that is how you are going to use that interrogativo, cuando. Okay? Next, mega, mega shout out for the 8 people in the house. And thank you so much for joining my live streaming. I'm so grateful. Muchísimas gracias por unirte a mí en directo. Do not forget to like my live streaming. And if you have any question, suggestions, comments about our topic today, feel free to chat in our live chat, okay? Isidro Galdores, present ma'am. Oh, thank you so much, Isidro. I'm so grateful that you are here now. I know that my live streaming, I really don't have a fixed schedule. It is just, if only I have a free time. So, yan po. Pasensya na po kayo, ha? Yeah, informative. Wow! Mega, mega shout out to my co-teacher before in the Philippines, June Salvatona, master, our master teacher from Baspiñas Science High School. Thank you so much for joining me, Sir June. Mark Lloyd TV, present, ma'am. Thank you. Ayman Liwanag. Oh, hello, Miss Kath. I was your student in Woodridge College, Philippines, when I was in high school. God bless you, ma'am. Take care. Oh, mega, mega shout out, Ayman. Thank you so much, Ayman. Oh, thank you po. I truly appreciate your presence, guys. Oh, Ayman, I remember, I think your section before in Woodridge is Einstein, right, Ayman? Oh, nakatuwa naman. Thank you, Sir Jun. More power. Thanks po for joining my live streaming. Anyways, okay. Continuamos. Okay. Donde, we are talking about where, and in Tagalog means saan. Okay. Donde in English is where, and in Tagalog or in Filipino, saan. Thank you so much, Sir June. Okay, so ejemplo, ¿dónde están mis gafas? ¿Dónde están mis gafas? So, we are talking about the glasses, the reading glasses. Okay? So, we use the verb están. In English, this is verb be, are, because glasses are plural. Okay? Always with that is why in Spanish, we use Ima Igbo, present teacher. Oh, mega mega shout out po, Emma. Thank you so much for joining my live streaming today. Thank you po. I'm so glad that you joined my live streaming today, people. Thanks a lot. Okay, so I use this sentence to tell you also the marcadores de lugar. Remember one time we discussed about the marcadores. So, for example, one moment, my marker, it's on the floor. Oh my God. Okay, so marcadores means, for example, debajo means under. For example, you can answer this question, ¿dónde están mis gafas? So you can tell where is it, ¿no? Debajo means under. Debajo means under, or for example, encima, en la mesa, on the table, okay, encima, on the table, or you can tell it that al lado de la tele, for example, no, al lado is side, and then delante, in front. Delante, and then what else? Detrás, behind you, detrás, con tilde, en la A, detrás. And then, entre, for ejemplo, entre. El marcador verde, entre, del azul o en el rojo, in the middle, entre. O a la derecha, present the teacher. Thank you po, Egbo Vlog. And then, Mikey Mikmik, thank you so much again. Thank you po for joining my live streaming. Appreciate ko po talaga. Maraming salamat po sa lahat. Okay, and then, what else? A la izquierda, okay? So that is the marcadores. Just a review, because I know that last time we discussed that already. Okay, so next. ¿Cómo? If you have questions, suggestions, just feel free to chat, okay? I will just continue reading the writings on the board. Okay, ¿cómo means how? In Tagalog, paano. Okay? Como, again, how, paano. So, como se pronuncia? For example, no? How are you going to pronounce the word como? For example, como. So, yan po yung ano. That is the example question using the word como. Okay? O como ba? Like, how's life going? Como ba la vida? How's life? ¿Cómo se escribe tu nombre? How are you going to write your name? What else? So that those are the examples, no? And then next, ¿por qué? ¿Por qué? Means why. ¿Bakit? ¿Vale? ¿Por qué? Why means bakit. So, let's use that in the sentence. ¿Por qué estudias español? ¿Por qué estudias español? Why do you study Spanish? ¿Por qué estudias español? ¿Por qué? ¿Por qué no? I mean, we are learning now by free, why not? And also, you know, in the BPO company in the Philippines, because it's booming now, I know that, I mean, one of my students sent me this information that in the Philippines, if you know bilingual languages, if you can speak rather bilingual English and Spanish, you will earn 70,000 to 90,000 a month in the BPO. So that is why also I really, I am aiming to learn a lot in Spanish because I know that maybe I can work also one day with using the Spanish language rather. I mean, now I am starting actually teaching a Spanish class. So it's a good job for me because I am learning harder para mas ano po, mas ginaganahan ako mag-aral ba? And mas dinodoble ko yung ano ko, yung pag-aaral ko sa Espanyol kasi bago ako magturo, kailangan ano, nabasa ko lahat, tapos na-check ko lahat ng ano ko, PowerPoint presentation ko. Sabi ko nga sa ano, sa estudyante ko kanina, sa mga students ko, they are foreign people actually. I told them, you know what, I'm so proud of myself today about the exercises. Because normally, before my class, I answer it alone and then I always ask my husband to check all the answers if correct. And today, I do not ask and all the answers are correct. I'm so proud of myself. Share ko lang po. Pasensya na. Ang dal-dal, no? Okay, next. So that is porque. Okay? Thank you. Mega, mega shout out for the 7,000 in the house. I'm so sorry about the light. I do not know where am I going to stay because if I'm going to open the window, the reflection of the light outside will reflect also. And since I only have this light because I don't have a ring light, hopefully if I have enough money, then I can buy one. Wow, congrats, teacher. Oh, thank you po, Emma. Yeah, I'm so happy and grateful, actually. It's been a month already that I started my Spanish class. My boss asked me, Catherine, are you confident enough to teach Spanish? And I said, yes, of course. Yes, of course. So that is why I really work hard to learn more about or to level up my Spanish skills, actually. So that is why also I love to do this live streaming because I know, at I mean, nakakatulong ako, sana, nakakatulong po ako sa inyo na nandyan po, na nakikinig sa akin. At also, I really wanted to grow my channel, my YouTube channel. That is why I keep on doing this. And aside from that, I am happy and grateful na meron akong YouTube channel kasi na de-distract ang aking ano, ang aking homesickness. Yes, there's no light if I will do it like this. Okay, can you read the writing if I'm going to hold the mini board like this? Okay. So, again, ¿por qué estudias español? Why do you study Spanish sa Tagalog, bakit ka nag-aaral ng Espanyol? Kasi malaking kita. Malaking kita kapag nagtrabaho tayo sa mga company na gusto nila na marunong mag-Spanish. Diba? Bakit naman hindi? Malay nyo. Ako nga, I cannot imagine that, I mean, for 2 years living here in Spain, that I can really teach Spanish. I know it's, I mean, nag-aral ako ng Espanyol ko dati sa San Carlos. Ano lang, 1 hour and a half lang yun, tapos 1 year lang. Kasi, and then after that, ano na ako, talagang ano, self-study na ako hanggang ngayon. Ano lang, super basa lang talaga ako. Kaya ganun. Okay, let's continue. Next, I'm sorry for the interruption, no? Dal-dal kasi. Okay, cual means which. Alin. So I put cual and es is cuales means for plural because you know here in Spain, they always have this singular and plural thing and masculine and feminino. One moment, I need to charge our laptop because it's blinking. Sorry for the disruption. maybe uno. Yeah. Dapat maaga ako mag-start kanina eh. Late na ako mag-ano. Okay, so next, qual is, oops, like this. Okay, there is no light reflection. Okay, so, qual es tu móvil? Qual es tu móvil? Which is your mobile phone? Okay, qual? O cuál es tu jaqueta, for example, no? Hay dos jaqueta or other things, okay? Cosas, ¿vale? Which of, for example, you're holding it? Which of these, for example? And then, ¿quién? ¿Quién es for singular? ¿Quiénes is for plural? Who? In Tagalog, sino, okay? Again, quién or quiénes, who. In Tagalog is sino. Ang galing ng mini board natin, no? Ang galing ng mini board natin, no? Kung saan-saan ko na ipapatong. Okay, so, ¿quién es tu mejor amigo? ¿Quién es tu mejor amigo? Means, that means, who is your best friend? Sino ang iyong matalik na kaibigan in Tagalog? Who is your best friend? In English, in Tagalog, sino ang iyong matalik na kaibigan. I am doing multitasking. Okay, so next. Okay, so next. ¿Quiénes is plural? For example, ¿quiénes son tus hermanas? ¿Quiénes son tus hermanas? Who are your sisters? In plural, okay? ¿Quiénes? ¿Quiénes? Okay? And then, next is ¿cuánto? ¿Cuánto, cuánta? ¿Cuánto es femenino, masculino? Cuánta is femenino. So, how much in English? And magkano sa atin, mga Tagalog? We are talking about quantity. Vale? Cuánto. We are talking about quantity. Okay? So, cuánto cuesta? For example, in the shop, if you are going to buy something, so normally you are going to ask that. Cuánto cuesta? How much it cost? Vale? In Tagalog, magkano? Cuánto cuesta? Cuánto cuesta? Magkano? So, this is how you are going to use the WH question in Spanish. Wow! Thank you po, Emma Igbo sa Palipad. Nakaka-touch naman po. Maraming salamat po. Na-touch naman po ako sa inyo. Salamat po sa Palipad. Okay, so again, this is how we are going to use this interrogativos. Oh, thank you po. Natuwa, naiyak naman po ako sa ano po ninyo, sa generosity po ninyo. Maraming salamat. Okay, so again, ¿qué is what or ano in Tagalog. So we are talking about que o que pasa, for example. Normally, I mean, here in Spain, they really ask that que pasa. But that is, que pasa is like, how are you? But they use this word que. It's normally, how are you? Que pasa? So, that's also a bit complication, a bit of complicated when you are, sometimes, when you hear that and then you're going to translate it. So, that is why I always told my students, the foreign students, sometimes if the literal translation from Spanish to English, sometimes it doesn't work because there are really words in Spanish that we cannot translate because no tiene sentido. So that's the reason actually. Like, for example, ¿cuántos años tienes? So, ¿cuántos? We are talking about your age, right? You cannot say how much. It's how old are you? So, it really depends how you are going to use in the sentence sometimes. Basta may ganon. Basta may ganon. May mga ganong ano ba, factor na iba yung ano po, iba yung paraan ng pag ano po nila. Kasi hindi naman talaga dapat tina-translate. Kasi, especially word by word. Kasi nga nagbabago po yung ano natin dyan. Nagbabago yung ating, yung meaning po ba? How are they going to? Ayan. So, if you have questions, comments, suggestions about our topic today, feel free to chat po para malaman ko po ang inyong mga opinions about our topic. Okay, so let's have another example. For example, ¿qué? ¿Qué prefieres comer? ¿Vale? ¿Qué prefieres comer hoy? ¿Qué prefieres comer hoy? So like, what would you like to eat today? Hoy is today. What would you like to eat today? Okay? ¿Qué prefieres comer hoy? What would you like to eat today? Let's erase the writing on the board and I'm going to write a new example. One moment. You know what, guys? Today is 8 days before Christmas. No? Ang bilis ng panahon. Time flies so fast. El tiempo pasa muy rápido, muy, muy rápido. What time now in the Philippines? It's 4 o'clock here in Spain. I think it's very late in the Philippines, like 11 o'clock. Okay. Again, if you have any questions, suggestions, please feel free to chat in our chat box, okay? So, let's start. ¿Qué haces? This is a very normal conversation. ¿Qué? Again, in Spanish, they always have two question marks. In the beginning of the sentence and at the end of the sentence of the question, rather. Okay? ¿Qué haces? So, I am talking to the second person. Haces means eres tú, you. So, what are you doing? ¿Qué haces? ¿O qué estás haciendo, no? Mi example antes, what are you doing? Because in Spanish, the difference between Spanish and English, in Spanish, they do not put normally the pronoun. That is automatic, that haces is the second person. Because the first person, because in Spanish, each pronoun, they have different verbs. Yo hago. Tú haces. Él hace. So, cada pronombres, I mean, cada panghalip sa Espanyol, iba-iba yung ano nila. Iba-iba yung, ano tawag nito? Iba-iba yung word. Kaya automatic yan sa kanila na, if I am using this verb, I am talking to the second person. Ganun. Sa English kasi, di ba, pinanilalagay natin yung, ano, yung panghalip, yung pronoun. So, in Spanish, they do not put the pronoun. Okay? Next. ¿Qué pasó? ¿Qué pasó? Pasó is past form. ¿Qué pasó? Okay? ¿Qué pasó? ¿Qué pasó? Ay, no. What's happening? What's happening? Sa Tagalog, anong nangyayari? Anong nangyayari? No? Anong nangyayari? What's happening? Okay? And then, ¿qué te pasa? This is a very normal conversation. Lagi ko tong naririnig po dito. ¿Qué te pasa? Ito yung mga ano, madalas kong naririnig kaya I put this as our example para mas madali pong ano ko sa inyo ba na this is really the normal conversation. ¿Qué te pasa? What's wrong with you? What's wrong with you? Okay? ¿Qué te pasa? Well, what's wrong with you? Isidro. Ako din, ¿qué te pasa? At ¿qué pasa? What is the difference? ¿Qué te pasa? Is that you are talking to the second person. Because remember, last time, right? That we talked about the reflexivos. So, we normally, if you are talking for the first person, ang gagamitin mo is me duele, for example, me entiendes. So, if I am telling you, te entiendes, I am talking to the second person, Isidoro. ¿Qué pasa? Is like indirecta, no? Indirecta, wala kang ina-address na kausap mo talaga. So, ito kasi, 'di ba, ginagamit natin 'to, 'di ba? Sa first person, like yo is para a mi. Para a mi, yo is me. Ati, I mean, para second person, tu is te. And then third person is le, o se. Umay kalamay, ¿qué pasó? ¿Qué pasó? ¿Qué pasó is what's happening? ¿Qué pasó? What's happening? Umay kalamay. Okay? So, Isidro, that is the difference between qué te pasa at qué pasa. Qué pasa. So, it's a normal conversation ba that you are asking, qué pasa? Okay? Next. One moment. Again, I'm sorry for the disruption. I need to charge my phone. Okay, so sorry for that again. Oh, I think this angle I am looking for. I know there's a light reflection if I'm going to put that way. How? Bakit may naririnig ako sa mga movie na kepasa ginagamit? Yeah, because that is also correct. Ukay kalamay. That is also correct. Kepasa. Kete pasa. Ang sabi ko nga kay Isidro, ¿qué te pasa? Is that you are talking to the second person. Te is para the second person sa kinakausap mo. ¿Qué te pasa? Or, pasa algo? Parang may ano ba? May nangyari ba? Parang pasa algo? Ganon. So, that is correct. ¿Qué pasa o qué te pasa? Yan po yung ano. Yan yung... Ang tawag ito? Yan lang po yung diferensya. Ay, no problem. Umay ka lang, ay. No problem po. Walang problema. So, di ba po, last time, remember that we are talking about reflexivos. So, if we are talking about reflexivos, we really put... The pronoun, the te, me, I know. Primero, the first person, me, M-E. And then, second person, te. And then, third person, se, o le. And then, plural, in plural form, nosotros, nos, vosotros, os. And then, and so on. So that is the purpose of putting that te and me and le. Okay? That is why they use the que te pasa, meaning I am talking to you. So if you are talking, for example, in general, and you are not addressing somebody, so you will just say, que pasa? O pasa algo, for example. Okay? That is the difference. Next. Okay. Next is, for example, que, okay, umay kalamay. Let's put an another example. Que le pasa a la chica, for example, no? Que le pasa. Okay? ¿Qué le pasa a la chica? Meaning, ¿qué le pasa? Le is for the third person. If you want to ask what happened to her. So, ¿qué le pasa? Ahora yo sé, ¿tama ba? Muy bien. Yo sé. Muy bien, muy bien. Spanish ko. Ahora yo sé. Muy bien. ¿Tama ba? Yes, that is correct. What are you doing? Tama ba? What are you doing? ¿Qué le pasa? Okay? ¿Qué le pasa a ella? Okay? So if like, anong nangyari sa kanya? This is, le refers to third person and te refers to second person. Okay? That is the difference. Le, te, and qué pasa. And qué pasa. What has happened to her? or what happened to her. Okay? Yes. Yes, what's happened to her pala. Yes, 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 le. Okay? So that is the difference of putting te, le, or nada. No pasa nada. That is correct also. ¿Qué pasa? Normally, I heard that a lot of time with my in-laws. ¿Qué pasa? O ¿qué te pasa, cariño? So, ¿qué te pasa, cariño? So, that means that that person is talking to me, the second person. ¿Qué te pasa, cariño? Maya, i-reply ko nga habang nag-work. Ay, marami salamat po. Alam niyo, natutuwa talaga ako po na nanonood po kayo sa akin. Maraming maraming salamat po. Ang lamig ng kamay ko, guys. Mainit. Buti na lang na itong scarf ko. Kahit nasa loob ako, ang lamig kasi ngayon. Talagang sinisipon ako sa lamig. Anyways, so again, thank you po for joining me today. Okay. Understand now the difference? So, let's see another example. Okay? For example, ¿qué me dijiste? ¿Qué me dijiste? Let's have another call. I think I need to buy another. I-share ko sa FB ko para mas marami. Oy, thank you po, my kalamay. Marami salamat po. And ask them also to like and subscribe. Please like and subscribe. The more, the merrier. Sana po maka-3K po ako this before the year end. 3K subscribers. Ano lang, dreaming, why not, di ba po? Que me. So I will try to use different pronombres, vale? Para maano nyo po, makita nyo yung pagkakaiba ng te, ng me, ng le. So, que me dijiste? What did you say? What? Porque dijiste es pasado. What did you say? Okay? So, I am referring to me, the first person. Soy yo. ¿Qué me dijiste? Porque estás hablando conmigo. Pues, ¿qué me dijiste? Parang, ¿anong sabi mo sa akin? Parang ganun. O, ¿qué compraste? O, ¿qué me compraste? What did you buy for me? So, that is actually the use of this. The me, the le, and the te. Because that refers to different pronouns. If that refers, if that is first person, second person, or third person. Okay? I hope that, I mean, that help you. My explanation. I mean, sana naiintindihan nyo po. Para, o, que te traigo? Que te traigo? I am talking to you. No, traigo is to bring. Okay? O, que quieres? Que ti digo? Que ti digo? Que me ves? Que me ves? Que me ves? I'm going to write here. Que me ves? Using the word me. Is a pronoun possessive? Posesivos. Posesivos. ¿Qué me ves? ¿Qué okay? ¿Qué me ves? What are you looking at me? What? Me. ¿Qué me ves? Okay? ¿Qué me ves? What are you looking at me? Paano natin na-translate sa Tagalog? Bakit ka nakatingin sa akin? Bakit ka nakatingin sa akin? Hindi eh. Ke is hindi naman bakit, 'di ba? Ang ke siko, hindi naman bakit ang ke sa is what, ano? Ah, ano ang tinitingin mo sa akin? Tama ba ang Tagalog ko? Diyos ko po, nalito na si Inday. Hindi na tama yung pag-ano. O, ¿qué necesitas? What do you want? ¿Qué necesitas? O, ¿qué quieres? No? These are very normal sentences here in Spain. ¿Qué necesitas? Okay? Or, ¿qué quieres? ¿Qué quieres? Okay? ¿Qué quieres? So this is very normal here. I always do, I mean, use this questions. ¿Qué necesitas? ¿O quieres algo? See you around. Oh, thank you po so much, Emma Egboya. See you around. See you next time po. I hope I can also visit your live streaming if I have my free time. Actually, at 6 o'clock, I have my class in the academy. So I'll just like, okay, I will do a very quick live streaming today because I don't have upload. I just try to be active ba in my YouTube channel. Okay, ¿qué necesitas y qué quieres is the same. What do you want? Okay, ano ang gusto mo? What do you want? So as you can see, in English, we have the pronoun in the sentence. But in Spanish, they do not put the word to. That is the second person, you. ¿Qué quieres tú? So that's automatic to them. They do not see. Bye po, Emma Igbo. God bless. And thank you so much po again for your donation. Thanks a lot. Okay. What do you want? So in Spanish, they do not normally put the pronoun, pronombres. It's automatic. Once that you already know the verb, ¿qué necesitas? What do you need? Yes. What do you need? ¿Qué quieres? What do you want? Thank you for that, Isidro. If you really know the verbs, because, for example, first person, yo quiero. I want, for example, yo quiero café. ¿Vale? I want coffee. Yo necesito. For example, yo necesito ir al banco. I need to go to the bank. So the verb changes. So that is why in Spanish, they do not put the pronoun because just the verb itself that will explain already to whom are you talking with. Yan kasi mali ko din dun sa Duolingo app nun eh. Ah, okay po. ¿Qué necesitas y qué quieres? But actually, in general term, Isidro, that is naman understandable if you are talking with a Spanish native. It's like, for example, if you are visiting a friend, they will just ask you, ¿qué necesitas? Or, ¿qué quieres? For example, if you want a drink or something. But anyway, that's true. Need and want. I need and wants. Know the difference. I need. I put the same word. Need. Okay? Yeah, same lang naman, 'di ba? Opo. Kasi meron naman talaga ditong mga words ba na ginagamit na Ano, parang sa Tagalog term din, di ba tayo? Mayroon tayong mga words na ginagamit natin na naiintindihan ng lahat. Parang ganun po. So, they normally ask that necesitas o quieres na parang same lang yung meaning nila. But anyway, at least that's good that you really know the difference between the two words, necesitas and quieres. Okay? Again, thank you so much po for your time, for joining me today. Binigyan niyo po ako ng panahon. Sige, yung panahon. Maraming maraming salamat. Okay, so, next. Alam niyo, ano, sabi, this is our topic also before in my class. And they are telling me, you know what? Like, you know what? They are like the Spanish words. It's very difficult sometimes. But it's okay. Poco poco. Yeah, poco poco. When I am giving another examples and explaining to them, they were like, oh no, Catherine, please do not complicate things. I want a simple explanation. And about the accent, I told them it is very important because the meaning, I mean, if you put the accent, that will change the meaning because I mean, that words, si aprendo un poco. Ah, oh, muchas gracias. Okay, so, next. Okay, you can ask also question without using the qué, cuántos, quieres, qué más. ¿Cómo? ¿Cuándo? ¿Cuánto? ¿Por qué? Because normally they can also ask questions without using those interrogativos. For example, for example, ha tenido. Ha tenido fever, for example, no? Ay, fever is English. Fiebre, perdón. Fiebre. Okay. Ha tenido fiebre. Have you had fever? Fever. Okay. Ha tenido fiebre. So, this is also another form of questioning in Spanish. Ha tenido fiebre. Has comido, for example. I'm talking to you. ¿Has comido? ¿Has? So, a third person, as second person. Second person. I am talking to you. A is third. So, that is el o ella o usted, perdón, o usted. So, that is the difference. ¿Has comido? Like, have you? ¿No? And ha tenido? Okay? So, that is the difference. Or you can say, tiene dolor de cabeza. Tiene dolor de cabeza. Tiene dolor de cabeza. Okay. Do you have cough? I headache. Do you have headache? So without also using the cuando, donde, etc. and so on, you can also ask this way, just using the verb. Okay, and putting, of course, the question mark in the beginning and at the end of the sentence. That is the, how you are going to ask questions.
Maestra, maya ko panoorin para mas maintindihan ko po, pero kasama pa rin ako sa live po, di po alis. Oy, maraming salamat, umay kalamay. Nakaka-touch naman po ang inyong presence. Marami, muchísimas gracias por unirte a mí en directo. Estoy muy, muy contenta a vosotros en mí en directo. Si queréis hablar conmigo, podéis chatear. Y luego voy a leer sus mensajes. Sois mensajes. Vosotros. ¿Ok?
So, I will make another example.
Perdón, profesora, ¿es necesita me quedarme los niños? Reply ko na mamaya. Muchas gracias. Hasta luego.
Ah, vale, Isidro. ¿Es necesito? ¿Eres tú?
You are going to.
Adiós, hasta luego. Okay, so let's have another example. Okay. Another example. For example, if you are in the restaurant and then you want to order a steak, and then normally the el camarero o la camarera pregunta si cómo prefieres tu carne, ¿no? If you want it well done or half cooked. So you're going to ask cómo okay, cómo prefieres tu carne. Okay, so how do you like your steak cooked? So you can say well done, bien, no, o tostada, un poco de yung medyo sunog ba ako kasi gusto ko yung well done eh, yung ano talaga, lutong-luto. Un poco tostada. Ay, tostado rather, ay karne. Tostado. Kasi mas anong tawag nito? Mas masarap kapag lutong-luto, diba? Yung may dugo kasi hindi ko gusto. Ay, ganun eh. Yung may dugo, hindi ko gusto. One moment. Ay, perdón. Es la carne tostada. Femini. No, la carne tostada. La carne tostada. Ay. Mali, ay, may kimik-mik. Tama po, profi. Marami salamat po. Muy hecho. Porque no me gusta con sangre. No me gusta. Yo no quiero comer a carne con sangre. Para mí es muy... Tiene sabor muy diferente. Tiene sabor muy diferente, ¿no? Okay. What else? What else? What do you want to ask about our topic today? If you have any question, let me know. People of the world. Again, okay, let's have a quick review. If we are going to write questions, do not forget to write the accent, el acento, this one. Because in Spanish, all the interrogativos rather, con tilde. Okay? Because there are words that when you put the accent, that change the meaning. Ito yung ano sa atin eh, parang same in spelling but different in meaning. Diba? May mga salita tayo na pareho ng pagsulat pero magkaiba ang kahulugan. Parang halimbawa, yung puno at puno. Diba? Sa Tagalog, meron tayong ganyan, yung stress. So, ganun din po sa Spanish. Puno. 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 So, ano? Yung full at saka the tree. Tama ba ako? Puno sa atin, di ba? Tagalog, puno. So, ganun yung ano. I am trying to explain to you how important is the accent in Spanish word because that really changed the meaning when you put the accent. Yung baka at baka, parang ganun sa atin yan eh, sa Tagalog, di ba? So, ganun din sa kanila. Meron ding ano yan. May important ba siya? Bakit siya nilalagay talaga? Okay? Porque. So, let's just have a quick review. And of course, when you write a question, they always put the question mark in the beginning and at the end of the sentence. ¿Cuál? It's just a quick review because ¿dónde? Then, ¿quién? ¿O quién es? That is plural. ¿Cuál o cuál es plural? ¿Cuánto? ¿O cuántos o cuántas? ¿Cuántas es para femenino? ¿Y cuánto es para masculino? ¿Cuántos, cuántas, plural? ¿Ok? Jerry Dison, shout out host. Oh, mega, mega shout out, Jerry Dison. Thank you so much for joining my live streaming today. I truly appreciate all your presence today. You are really giving me a lot of joy every time na sinasamahan niyo po ako sa ating live streaming. Again, so, ke? What is ke? Let's have a review. This is our generalization. Ke is what? Ano? in Tagalog.
And por qué is why? Bakit? Bakit? Por qué? Bakit? ¿Cuál is which? ¿Cuáles is plural, vale? Which is alin. Alin dito. Okay? Which. ¿En dónde? ¿Dónde? ¿Dónde estás? Where are you? Very good, Mikey, make me. ¿Dónde estás? ¿Dónde estás? Is where. Saan. Okay. Saan. And then, no, no puedo go si Inday. ¿Quién? Who? Sino? Who? Itong maganda sa mini board natin. Kasi diba, nabubuhat ko siya. ¿Quién? Who? Sino? Okay? And then, ¿cuánto? ¿Cuánto dinero? ¿Cuánto dinero? Is how much? How much? Mucho dinero. Mucha paciencia. Sin dinero, mucha paciencia. Okay, you have a lot of patience. So, this are the interrogativos. Estas palabras. Estas palabras son interrogativos. In English, these are the WH questions. And it is very important because, for example, if you are new here in Spain, these are the basic words that you are going to ask some. For example, if you are walking down the street, then you can ask, for example, ¿Cómo te llamas? ¿Cómo te llamas? What's your name? ¿Cómo te llamas? Or, ¿cuál es tu número? ¿Cuál es tu número de teléfono? Okay? Actually, that is so weird. Because in Spanish, we are going to ask, ¿cuál es tu número de teléfono? Because in English, we are not going, which is your number? That is, what is your number? Right? So that's a bit confusing. Again, that's a bit confusing. That is why I told you before that sometimes translation is not a good idea because it doesn't make sense when you're going to translate in Spanish. Like, how old are you? That is, ¿cuántos años tienes? Okay, sí. How old are you? ¿Cuántos años tienes? And then when we are, ¿cuánto? Anyway, so we are talking also, ¿cuánto? How much? Is how old are you? That is, how old are you? Okay? So, that is our topic for today, people. I hope that you are going to, or you learn something today. I hope that we have a very productive live streaming today. So if you have any questions, feel free to chat in our live chat if you have any comments, opinions, suggestions, or questions. Before we end, then we can have a quick Q&A, question and answer portion. You can ask everything and anything in our live chat. You can ask anything and everything, our topic today. Okay, so again, please do not forget to like and subscribe to my channel and
Please help me grow my channel by sharing my videos. And again, I am so thankful, and I hope that this Saturday I will be doing my live streaming on Saturday after my class. So I hope that you can join me also this coming Saturday. Normally, every Saturday, I do my live streaming. That is why, please, if you are not busy, I normally do my live streaming in the afternoon, Spanish time, because I work in the morning. Muchas gracias, Profi. Que tengas muy buen día. Salamat po, madam. Igualmente, igualmente, Mikey Mikmik. So, mega, mega shout out for the 5,000 in the house. Again, thank you so much for joining my live streaming today. If you don't have any questions or any comments, if you have a request for our next topic, feel free to chat and I am happy to prepare that topic. So, if you have any suggestions, for example, next live streaming, okay, for example, Catherine, can we study, for example, about pronombres, por ejemplo? Please feel free or just comment down below if you have any suggestions for our next meeting, okay? So, again, thank you so much. This is Catherine Fernandez Proud Pinay asking you to like and subscribe to my channel and pon me gusta y suscríbete. Y luego, compartir, por favor, para tenemos más gente en mi indirecto. So, God bless you, everyone, and see you this coming Saturday. Hasta luego. Hasta la próxima. Adios. Maraming salamat po sa inyong pagbisita. Paalam. Hasta luego.